No, it cannot be done. It cannot be done. Here on the shore of the final sea, our windows open on unreality. The bitter rubric of the sinking sun, ne plus ultra. This is the western edge of the established world, the ocean wall beyond which none may pass. To pass would lead to nothing at all.
Yes, but it can be done. It can be done. Wise men have proved the world is round. Follow the sun to the west, and you are bound to come on unknown lands which know the sun. Westward! Westward! Legendary isles call our ships to sea, and who knows where we shall come to port. We know there is something there! From nowhere. They call me Christopher Columbus. My trade is the sea. I am a stranger in Spain. A voice crying in the wilderness. I knock at the doors of kings to offer them an empire. My name is Christopher, that is the bearer of Christ. My name is Columbus, that is the dove. You remember the dove of Noah? It flew across the waters, bearing a branch of olive.
To carry Christ to the unknown world.
That is my mission.
You You cannot do that alone. You will need material things. You will need official support. And I fear you will meet with a refusal. Their Catholic majesties are not so easy to approach. The Queen's confessor now is Hernando de Talavera. I must warn you. Talavera is a holy man, but he is not like myself. He has not interest in knowledge for itself. He has no interest in world glory. He is a servant of God. He may very possibly think your scheme is mad.
Where can I find him?
He is at the moment in Cordova.
I will tell Talavera the truth. That is all he can ask for.
Finding his way by starts and gleams, plotting imponderable schemes, a haggard pilgrim drunk with dreams, he plods the dusty land of Spain to call upon the indifferent court, on priests and nobles for support, but he will call in vain, in vain! The man the populace despise. There is a flame that never dies upon the altars of his eyes. He will not break. He will not bend. His hands are tied by church and state. He runs the gauntlet of the great, but he shall conquer in the end.
The game is beginning. Now I am on the move. Whether they want to or not, they will have to listen. I am Christopher, the bearer of Christ. I am the dove that travels the world. And the words that I speak are the words that I hear. And the words that I hear are the words of God. I am the last apostle. Let them give me a ship, and I will carry Christ to the world that no one knows. A bridge across the future. Look out there! All you see is a waste of waters, the heaving bosom of the indifferent, childless sea, the drunken marble of the toppling wave, the edge of the horizon of the explosive filigree of spindrift. That is all you see. But I see so much more. In my hand, I hold the key of the West. I have come to Spain with that key in my hand. I shall open my hand to the powers of Spain and say, do you see this? This is the key to glory, the key to a new world. Will you allow me to use it? That is what I shall say to the powers of Spain. And whether they want to or not, they will have to listen.
Señor Columbus, we, Isabella, Queen of Castile and Aragon, have listened to all you say. Our father confessor told us that you were mad, but your words have stirred our fancy. You ask us to give you a ship and to authorize you to sail to the end of the world. You ask us to send you out into an ocean of guesswork.
Give me a ship, and you need not guess any more. Only give me a ship!
We are not accustomed to being interrupted and questioned. I will refer you to a royal commission consisting of wise men and fathers of the church. They shall decide whether you are right. They shall decide whether there is a land in the West.
But how can they know? How can they know I am wrong until I have proved myself right? How can they know what there is in the West while the West is still uncharted? Here am I. Give me a ship. Let me go to the West and let them prove me wrong.
Silence, senor!
Have I not quoted you back the prophet Isaiah? Have I not quoted you back the prophet Esdras? Have I not told you the words that I hear myself in the night, the still, small voice of Almighty God himself?
Senor Columbus, I call you to order! What you have just said precludes further debate. You have stood there and thrown God in our teeth. My patience is now at an end.
And so is mine, my lord. You and your royal commission. For 3 days you have balked the issue. 3 days of prevarication and obscuration. 3 days of the closed mind and the lying tongue. I have heard the opinions of your learned body. They are like so many dead leaves, blown hither and thither in an endless maze of ancient ignorance and prejudice. A labyrinth of lies.
My fellow commissioners, this man has convicted himself out of his own mouth as either a willful heretic or a madman. There is no need for me to conclude my summary. This man has asked us for our official approval. There is only one answer to give.
No! 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 No!
The golden bowl, and gone the morning dream. No one can now redeem the desolated soul. Alone, he toils along a never-ending street, where all his hopes are wrong, and all his life defeat.
Look at the sunset, when the sky is a lather of crimson and coral, and the bulging sun, overripe with knowledge, glides back into the womb of the sea. Don't you feel, as you watch him sink, don't you feel an envy of the sun? It is so easy for him to travel out to the west and see what none of us have seen. But first, I must call at Cordova. I know a woman in Cordova. I have to say goodbye to her. I haven't seen her for years. Beatriz Enriquez.
May I come up?
I told you it is no use. So you are leaving Spain? By land or sea?
By sea, from Palos. Beatrice, since you will not let me come up, I will take this rose from your courtyard, and I will be on my way.
But, Christopher, wait. Wait! You have no right to take a rose from my courtyard. You have no right to come here at all. But now you have come, you cannot leave me like that. Yes, you had better come up.
So, my son, you are leaving Spain.
I am leaving Spain. For good.
No, my son, do not be stubborn. Granada is about to surrender. Take a horse, the best horse that you can, and ride to Granada at once. Wait for the queen when she enters Granada. Press your suit while the moment is ripe. Ride to Granada at once. Ride to Granada!
From where I stand on the top of this turret, the whole of this city of Granada is a sea of sound and color. Brass and brocade, jewels and banners, the plumes of the knights like spray when the sun is dancing on the sea.
We'll be right back.
royal procession is winding through the resounding streets. Ferdinand in silver and gold, Isabella in diamonds. Give me a ship, Your Majesty! Give me a ship! Need we delay any longer?
On this day, the 13th of April, in the year of our Lord, 1492. In the name of the Holy Trinity and Eternal Unity, we, Don Ferdinand and Donna Isabella, by the grace of God, King and Queen of Castile, have seen a patent of grace signed with our names, sealed with our seal, drawn up as follows.
They have given me all that I asked. Admiral of the untraveled ocean, viceroy of the unknown world, they have promised me 3 ships. I shall sail from Palos.